Did you know that an average millionaire is estimated to have 7 streams of income? Now, it does not necessarily mean that they have 7 different jobs. It's just that most millionaires have figured out ways to rake in additional income doing things other than what they do primarily. When you're trying to save up money for something special or attempting to build an empire, passive income is something that could help you achieve that goal. And you've probably already heard the expression, make money while you sleep. That's the biggest draw that tempts people to earn passive income. So let's dig a little deeper into what passive income actually means. Well, passive income is defined as the money you make that does not require you to do a lot of active work to continue making it. Adding passive income streams to your portfolio can help you increase your earnings, security, and accelerate your financial goals in tremendous ways. In this video today, we will look upon the top 10 best passive income ideas to make you earn extra money while still keeping your full-time gig. So, let's begin. Number 10, rent out your car. One of the easiest ways to earn passive income is to rent out your car. Instead of simply sitting in your garage, your car can make some extra cash on the side. This idea is a no-brainer, and you can use this as your second or third passive income stream alongside others. If sharing a car is not ideal for you, but you still want to yield extra cash off of your car, you can consider sticking an ad on the side of your car. It is estimated that one rideshare driver makes an extra $250 a month from car wrap ads. Moreover, you could also earn $100 a month from a platform like Carvertise with no upfront costs. You'll likely have to answer questions about your driving habits, and you'll have a better chance of getting selected if you live in a bigger city and drive a lot. Number 9, make money off of your extra space. This straightforward idea takes advantage of space that you're not using anyway and turns it into a passive money-making opportunity. If you're going away for the summer or have to be out of town for a while, or maybe even just want to travel, consider renting your current space while you're gone. You can rent out your room through Airbnb and use its price calculator to see how much money you could make in your area. Hosting guests via Airbnb can help you turn your extra space into additional income and upscale your money-making game. Although it might feel weird leaving your space in the hands of strangers, don't worry, Airbnb has up to $1 million of insurance in case something goes wrong. There's also a rating system so you can review the renter's reputation before letting them rent your place. Number 8, finance a business. One of the ways to build passive income is to invest in tangible assets. You can start by investing in small businesses. So, how to jump on the bandwagon? Well, it's pretty simple. Provide them the funds they need in order to grow. Often, investments in private businesses are reserved for high net worth individuals, but there are other ways you can invest in a business. For example, several years ago, both Lyft and Uber were looking for private investors to invest in their companies. Today, they're worth billions of dollars. But you as an investor would get to reap that benefit if they go public via an initial public offering, short for IPO. IPO refers to the process of offering shares of a private corporation to the public in a new stock issuance. In an IPO, a company's owners sell a portion of the firm to public investors. If you have capital and meet certain qualifications, you can buy a percentage of the business through the public offering. And as the market share price of the business you have invested in increases, so do your returns. Number 7, invest in real estate investment trusts. Commonly known as REITs, real estate investment trusts own and manage real estate. Not just any real estate, but commercial properties like office buildings, rental centers, large apartment complexes, and other types of non-residential properties. REITs are investment vehicles that hold property within them, and you as the owner get to benefit from the gains, refinances, sale, and income on the property. You can repurchase the REITs on the stock market just like any other company or dividend stock. You'll make whatever the REIT pays out as a dividend, and the best REITs have a record of increasing their dividend on an annual basis, so you could have a growing stream of dividends over time. But just like dividend stocks, you'll have to be able to pick the good REITs, meaning you'll need to analyze each of the businesses that you potentially want to buy. And while it's a passive activity, you can lose a lot of money if you don't know what you're doing. One of the best platforms to invest in REIT is Fundrise. With just $500, you can start investing in real estate via a starter portfolio from Fundrise. Number 6, invest in a high-yield savings account. Online banks have started to offer attractive interest rates that can help you make money on your savings. Since interest rates have been rising, putting more money into a savings account at an online bank can generate a safe passive income stream. So if you don't want to think much about your money but want it to work for you, a basic place to put your money is in a high-yield savings account. To make the most of your savings account, you want to do a quick search of the nation's top savings accounts. As mentioned before, it's usually much more advantageous to go with an online bank rather than your local ones because you'll be able to select the top rate available in the country. And you'll still enjoy a guaranteed return of principal of up to $250,000 if your financial institution is backed by the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, or FDIC in short. Being insured by the FDIC means you are protected when financial institutions fail and are forced to close their doors. The FDIC insures up to $250,000 per depositor and FDIC insured bank and for each ownership category. Number 5, create an app. If you're a developer or programmer, you might want to try creating apps as a passive income stream, make that upfront investment, and then reap the reward over time. Your app might be a game or one that helps mobile users perform some hard-to-do functions. Once your app is public, users download it, and you generate the income. You can go about it in two ways. First, you can charge a fee for people who want to buy your app, and second, you can make your app free and monetize it with ads. You can monetize your app in several ways, including running in-app advertising, offering paywalled content, and charging for premium features. If your app gains popularity or you receive feedback, you'll likely need to add incremental features to keep the app relevant and popular. Number 4, practice P2P loan. A peer-to-peer or P2P loan is a personal loan made between you and a borrower, facilitated through a third-party intermediary such as a Prosper or Lending Club. Let's say someone needs to borrow $20,000 to consolidate their debt. They create an account with Lending Club, and depending on their credit history and income, they're given an interest rate on the loan. You, as an investor, also create an account with Lending Club and buy the debt. When the borrower makes monthly payments, the principal and interest are paid to you in your Lending Club investment account. What's great about this is that you simply lend your money and you get paid back the amount that you have loaned, which is the principal amount and the interest that has been charged on that loan. So this means as a lender, you earn income via interest payments made on the loans. But because the loan is unsecured, you face the risk of default, meaning you could end up with nothing. To cut that risk, you can either diversify your lending portfolio by investing smaller amounts over multiple loans or analyze historical data on the prospective borrowers to make informed picks. This way, you can choose the borrowers and spread your investment amount out to mitigate your risk. Number 3, use affiliate marketing. Affiliate marketing is an income idea that requires you to have a website or platform you can use to promote other companies or affiliates. And when someone uses your affiliate link to purchase a product or sign up for a service, you get paid. Amazon might be the best known affiliate partner, but eBay, A1, and ShareASale are among other larger names too. When a visitor clicks on the link and makes a purchase from third-party affiliate, you earn a commission. You can post a link to product reviews and share affiliate links to the product on Amazon, and you receive a few percent of every sale as a commission. This is one of the best passive income ideas for those blogging consistently about a topic for which they can recommend related products. The commission might range from 3 to 7%, so it'll likely take significant traffic to your site to generate some income. And if you can grow your following or have a more lucrative niche, you may be able to make some serious coin. But remember, you don't necessarily have to start a blog per se. Some people are crushing it with affiliates using YouTube, podcasts, and other avenues. Number 2, sell information products. Another popular idea for passive income is establishing an information product, such as an ebook or an audio or video course, then kicking back while cash rolls in from the sale of your product. For instance, you can create an online course to teach anything from algebra to guitar on platforms like Udemy or Teachable. The best part about this passive income idea is that once you do this initial work of setting up your course, you will continue to get paid when people take it. Similarly, blogging is another way of creating an information product for readers online. As a travel blogger, you can set up a WordPress blog and share your experiences with your readers. Whenever you go to a new place, you can write about all the cool things you saw and experienced there. Blogging has helped countless entrepreneurs earn passively through affiliate links, courses, sponsored posts, products, book deals, and many more. Number 1, invest in dividend-paying stocks. Investing in stocks that pay quarterly dividends is the oldest and one of the best ways to generate passive income. If you consistently invest money into dividend stocks, you can amass a nice residual income over time. Dividend investing in particular has been a profitable endeavor for many other investors. According to Forbes contributor Brett Owens, dividend investors who look ahead have the potential to score annual returns of 15, 20, or even 25% if only they pick the right dividend-paying stocks. Let's say you buy shares of Colgate-Palmolive stock. When you buy stocks, the price is likely to rise over time. You will get paid for each share of stock you own. Over the past 7 years, Colgate-Palmolive has paid between 34 and 68 cents each quarter for every single share owned by stockholders. So passive income streams like these can definitely help elevate your earnings and fill in the gap that your 9-to-5 job can't fill on its own. If you're looking to expand your income streams, the passive income ideas on this list can help you do that. Whether you're looking to start a blog, an agency, or create profitable apps, you'll find that there's money to be made in all these areas. All you gotta do is just get started. That's it from our list of top 10 best passive income ideas. Thank you so much for watching the video. What particular passive income idea have you given a try on your own? Let us know in the comments below. Please leave a thumbs up and share the video if you liked it. For more videos like this, click on our channel and don't forget to subscribe. See you guys in the next one.